Good afternoon. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Muslima. I am 14 years old. I study at school Genius Education at 8th class. I like learning different languages. I like English very much. I have been learning English for 4 years. In future, I want to be an English interpreter. I am good at school lessons and I like participating in different competitions in order to test out my knowledge. That's why I am here. So there were a lot of interesting topics, but to my mind, I have chosen an exciting topic. My topic is about interesting capitals. The best way for anybody to become educated about the world around him is to experience the world firsthand and to see different cultures and lifestyles up and close. People say different countries have different cultures. There is no people without a temple. There are a lot of different countries in the world and each country has its own capital. Today, I would like to tell you about interesting capitals of the world. First of all, the word capital originates from the Latin word capitalis, meaning of the head. As the city at the head of the territory, it's linked to the state and hosts the seat of government, and if they exist, usually royalty too. The most beautiful capital city is London, the city of kings and queens. London is situated on the River Thames, and that is one of the reasons how it became so beautiful. It is also famous for its arts, education, entertainment, fashion, tourism, and historical places. The capital of England is also known as the artistic capital of the world, probably because of the fine architectural style of buildings. And if you visit the city, you should visit the London Eye, Big Ben, Tower Bridge, Hampton Court, Buckingham Palace, Palace of Westminster, and other historical places. Another, the most beautiful capital city is Paris. Paris, the city of love, the city of lights, the international capital of style, is the capital of France. Paris is famous for its arts, fashion, and monuments. We all have once in a lifetime longing to see, to have a glimpse of the Eiffel Tower and to see what lies at the top. The city is also famous for its history. The tourist attractions there include the Eiffel Tower, Louvre Pyramid Museum, Notre Dame de Paris, Disneyland, Arc de Triomphe, and other interesting places. Washington is one of the interesting capitals of the world. Washington, D.C., simply known as Washington or D.C., is the capital of the United States. This beautiful city lies on the north bank of the Potomac River and exhibits 4 distinct seasons. It is a city famous for being up-to-date in every field. And there situated the White House, a house of American president. And places of interest there include the White House, Lincoln Memorial, National Museum of Natural History, National Zoological Park, and other places. Moscow is one of the most popular capitals of the world. Moscow is the capital of Russia, and it is also the largest city in the European continent. It is the 9th most expensive city in the world, 10th largest city according to population, and one of the fastest growing destinations in the world. Earlier, it was referred as a city by the Moscow River, and that's how it got its name. Tourist attractions there include the Moscow Kremlin, house of Russian president, Moscow Museum of Modern Art, Red Square, City Basil's Cathedral, and other places. Tokyo is a beautiful capital city. Tokyo, officially known as the Tokyo Metropolitan, is the capital of Japan and also the largest metropolitan area in the world. Apart from being beautiful, Tokyo is famous for its nightlife, shopping, transportation, and trendy fashion scene. It has also been ranked in the best all-over experience category by the Trip Advisor. Places of interest there include the Meiji Shrine, Tokyo Sky Tree, Disneyland, Disney Sea, Dōjinshi Park, and other places. So there are so many interesting capitals in the world, and each capital is famous enough. Each capital has many places of interest. But what a pity that we have not much time, and I cannot tell you about other capitals. To conclude, I want to add a few words about the capitals of the world. Capitals need to be protected, but also able to exert control and project unity. For that reason, many capitals are built in the center of the countries. They need to be seen as the representative and accessible places. And that's all from me. Thank you for your attention. Malaysia.